Hello and welcome everyone, I am Tiberius, back with another video. Today I'll be walking you through day 23 of TryHackMe's Advent of Cyber 2024 event. Yes, sadly the event is almost over, but I hope everyone has been having fun. If you're watching this video and have no idea what I'm talking about, let me briefly explain. TryHackMe is a cybersecurity-focused online learning platform offering a wealth of resources designed to cater to all skill levels, from beginners to experienced professionals. Each year in December, they host Advent of Cyber, an event where participants tackle new beginner-friendly challenges daily, starting on December 1st and culminating on Christmas Eve, December 24th. Every challenge is completely free, and for each correctly answered question, you'll earn a raffle ticket for a prize draw at the event's conclusion. This year, the total prize pool exceeds $100,000, and those who complete all tasks by December 31st will qualify for the grand prize draw, which includes DEF CON tickets and accommodation. If you find this video helpful, please give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and share your thoughts in the comments. Now, let's jump into day 23. Okay, so we're on task 29, hash cracking. Day 23, you want to know what happens to your hashes. So here's the story. Glitch has been investigating how Mayor Malware funds his shady operations for quite some time. Recently, the mayor disposed of various old electronic equipment. One was an old tablet with a cracked screen. Being an avid connoisseur of active and passive reconnaissance who does not mind dumpster diving for the greater good, Glitch quickly picked it up before the garbage truck. Surprisingly, despite being in a terrible condition with a cracked and hazy screen, the tablet still turns on. Browsing through the various files, one PDF file that caught his attention was password protected. It is time you work with Glitch to discover the password and unlock any evidence lurking there. So we have a few learning objectives, learning about hash functions and hash values, saving hashed passwords, cracking hashes, and finding the password of a password protected document. Okay, so today we do not need to start the attack box, but we do need to start the VM, which we can do down here. Okay, and it starts in split view. So what we can do is go down here, click view in full screen. It's going to open in a new tab. And then if we click back, we can click exit split view. And then we can just switch between the views using tabs in your browser. If you have access via the VPN, you can also SSH into the machine at whatever IP address displays here for you, using the username and password here as well. So we need to crack a password found in a breach database and also find the password of an encrypted PDF. Okay, so we switch over to the VM interface in the other tab. And we cd into the AOC 2024 directory, we can see that the hash has been saved into this hash1.txt file, and we can cat that out. Now, right now, we don't know what kind of hash this is, so we have to identify it. Luckily, there is this hash-id Python file that we can run, and that should be able to tell us. So the first thing we need to do is select this hash, and then if we run the Python file, and then right click, we should be able to paste that hash that we just selected and press enter. And it says possible hashes, we have SHA-256, HAVAL-256, and then least possible hashes here. So we can use our brains and figure this is very likely just to be SHA-256. If we wanted another way of doing this, there is another tool that I use all the time called Name That Hash, and it's actually in the Kali repos. So I'm going to switch to my Kali box and show you how you can use that to identify the hash as well. So on Kali, you can install Name That Hash by typing sudo apt install name-that-hash. I already have it installed, and if you want to run it, you don't actually have to type the full name. You can just do nth for name that hash. If you have the hash in your copy buffer already, you can just add --text and then paste it and then press enter. And what I like about name that hash is it will tell you, okay, the most likely was SHA-256, but it'll then tell you what options to use with various hash cracking tools. In this case, Hashcat's mode 1400. And John the Ripper's raw-SHA-256. If you have it in a file, and I also have the file hash1 here, you can also use name that hash file hash1.txt, and it will spit out exactly the same results. Okay, but let's try actually cracking this hash with John. I'm just going to clear so we get a nice clear screen there. So if we type John, we know the format is raw-sha256. We're going to use the word list in user share word lists rocku.txt, and then we're just going to pass it hash1.txt. And so this is going to run through all the words in the rocku.txt file. It's going to create their SHA-256 hash and compare it to the hash in hash1.txt. And we see the session completed and we didn't get any hits on the password. And that's because the password isn't in rocku, but maybe it's based off one of the words in rocku. It's just been mutated a bit. And so what we can do is we can look at John the Ripper's word list mutation rules. So what we can do here is we can go to vim and etsy john.conf, and we can search for the list.rules.wordlist. There it is. So this is the word list mode rules. And so you can actually see which of these mutations are going to apply if we use this rule set. So it's going to try words as they are. It's going to lowercase every pure alphanumeric word. It's going to then capitalize. It's going to do a bunch of stuff with all the words in rocku.txt. So let's try that. We'll go back to the command that we were using before. And all we need to do here is add rules equals word list. And there we go. Now we found it. FluffyCat12. So that is the password. And so what we can do here is we can copy this and paste it into the answer here. Submit that. Excellent. Okay, the next thing we want to do is crack the password protected file private.pdf. And to do this with John, we need to actually extract the hash of whatever this PDF file is and put it into a format that John will understand. And luckily, John comes with a bunch of tools for doing this. We can actually see them if we do ls /opt/john*2john*. So there's a bunch of scripts in here for converting various files or various password protected files into a crackable hash that John can understand. This is a PDF file. So obviously what we need to do is use PDF to John. And we're going to use the Perl version. And if we do private.pdf, we just hit enter, we'll get the John hash format out. So this is what John understands. So what we actually need to do is redirect that into a file. I'm just going to call it pdf.hash. And if we just cat that, we can see it's exactly the same kind of thing, right? So all John has done here is it's read the password protected PDF, it's extracted the hash of that password that's there to protect the PDF, and put it into a format that John will understand for cracking. So now we can crack this hash. We're going to use the single rule set. We're going to use the word list that is provided for us by TryHackMe. It's just in the Advent of Cyber 2024 directory. It's just called wordlist.txt. Hey, Tiberius from the future here, and what passed me over there failed to explain was why we're using a separate word list this time. Why not use the rocku word list again? Well, we absolutely could, and in the real world we might. But as the TryHackMe walkthrough explains, Mayor Malware picked a password which doesn't exist in these public word lists and isn't derived from a word found there either. Instead, we can try creating a word list from scratch, containing words we may suspect Mayor Malware to use. Words like Fluffy, Fluffy Cat, Mayor, Malware, and Mayor Malware. Those are the five words which TryHackMe saved into the wordlist.txt file for us to use. On a real engagement, you might use words relating to the company you're pen testing, the town or city the company is based in, local sports teams, etc. You could even scrape the company website to find the names of products and services using a tool like Cool, spelled C-E-W-L, to generate a word list automatically. Now that's explained, back to past me. And we'll give it the location of this hash file that we created. And there we go. So now we've cracked the password, it's Mayor Malware in LeetSpeak. But we're not done yet. We actually need to use this password because this hasn't actually unlocked the PDF at all. It's just cracked the password for the PDF. So what we need to do is actually use this to unlock the PDF, and we'll convert it to text so it's more readable. So what we can do is do PDF to text, private.pdf, and then use the UPW option. We're going to copy the password, hit enter, and looks like it's done something. What it has actually done is created private.txt. So what it did was it opened the private.pdf using the password here, and it converted the PDF to a TXT file. And if we just head the private.txt file, we can get the flag. We can copy that and complete the day. If you want to learn more about cryptography, we recommend the cryptography module. If you want to practice more hash cracking, there is even a John the Ripper, the basics room. Thank you for joining me for day 23 of TryHackMe's Advent of Cyber 2024. I hope you learned some new things about cracking hashes and extracting hashes from different password protected files. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and let me know in the comments if you've enjoyed this year's Advent of Cyber as much as I have. Remember, you still have until the end of the month to complete every task for a chance at winning DEF CON tickets, so keep at it, and happy hacking!